A winch and a heron. Today, across continents and time zones, the world goes green as millions of people become Irish for the day in honour of Ireland and St. Patrick. That our small Atlantic island should inspire such global affection is due in no small part to the nobility or the uisleacht of our people, a people who time and again saw to it not just to make the difference, but to be the difference in parts of the world visited by war or famine or destruction. Even now as I speak, in remote field clinics, at feeding stations and at border crossings, there is an Irish voice, there is an Irish man or Irish woman bringing not just help, but confidence, not just hope, but indeed love. So on St. Patrick's Day, we can say that from this small green island on the periphery of Europe, time and again, and in every generation, we have helped to transform people's circumstances and given them a future. In recent years, that's exactly what we had to do at home. I know the process of transforming Ireland has been extremely difficult, in many aspects galling for you. The shock of the fall was followed by the seemingly endless sacrifice by you and your families. But at last, and thanks to you and to your patience and your resolve in putting Ireland first, we are now back on the road to recovery. Yes, we have a way to go, but we have made that all-important start. As Taoiseach on this St. Patrick's Day, I say a warm thank you for all you have done to rescue our country. But on this special day for Ireland and the Irish, we celebrate above all our enduring wealth. That's a wealth that survives intact, immutable, in our people, in the territory of our heart and our imagination. It is from that place, on this island, I wish you and your families a happy St. Patrick's Day. May the immigrant St. Patrick bless us and keep us all year. Banach the Nefela Padraig Diaf Galair.